First, the Rocket City. In a decade, Alabama's largest city, according to the planning department for the city of Huntsville, it's happening. And while progress is good, it isn't without risk. More people means more lives in the path of severe weather. And that begs the question, what steps would emergency teams need to take in order to protect those lives? Tonight, WHNT News 19 meteorologist Jake Reed takes action to get answers. Jake?
Hey, Jerry, new roads, new schools, new parks. Those are just a few perks of living in an area that is growing. The problem, the same areas growing here in the Tennessee Valley are where severe weather and tornadoes happen the most. It's a sight and a sound. People in Limestone County have faced over and over again.
We're used to tornadoes here.
Limestone County EMA Director Rita White saw the damage firsthand in 2011 and again in 2014.
A lot of damage. Had about 150 homes completely destroyed. We seem to be real susceptible to tornadoes these days.
More tornadoes and more people. The population of Limestone County projected to double within the next 10 years.
Where it used to be farmland is now subdivisions.
Creating a few challenges for emergency managers.
There are going to be a lot more structures affected. You know, more damage, more people to try to protect.
But officials are ready. Two new public storm shelters are in the works at Woolly Springs Baptist Church and at the Owens Volunteer Fire Department on Glaze Road.
It's something that we have to do because of this spread of population in that area.
A sense of community is what keeps people coming back even after major disasters.
You know, those communities, they come together and they help each other.
That's something White hopes doesn't change no matter the population. If you are new to the area or you aren't sure where your nearest storm shelter is, we have got a thorough list of shelters all across the Tennessee Valley right now on WHNT.com. Melissa?